Once called the most terrible of all the ministers of death, smallpox was once a major killer disease, wiping out swathes of the human population. Smallpox was eradicated by 1979, but what if it came back? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm Rebecca Felgate, and today we're asking, what if we had another smallpox outbreak? Before we get into this video, I just want to remind you guys to subscribe to our channel and hit that like button if you enjoy our content. Smallpox was a savage killer. In the 20th century alone, it killed between 300 to 500 million people. But after British doctor Edward Jenner found a cure and pioneered vaccinations, gradually the disease was eliminated. By 1972, most countries stopped handing out the vaccine to children, and by the 1980s, it was obsolete. But what if it came back? While there has not been a smallpox case in almost 40 years, smallpox still exists in a small handful of laboratories across the world. These labs are closely guarded, but mistakes do happen. In 1978, a British microbiologist accidentally let the disease loose, killing a woman and sparking a scare on both sides of the Atlantic. This woman, Janet Parker, was the last known person to die of the disease. The important things you should have picked up on so far are that vaccination stopped over 40 years ago, and that laboratories do still have the disease under lock and key. Interesting. This means that the disease could maliciously be unleashed. There has also been some suggestion in the science community that some biologists may be able to create a synthetic strain of smallpox. Recently, Canadian researchers managed to recreate horsepox with some mail-order DNA and a little seed money. Worrying, as this means that scientists may be able to recreate the killer human version. Real or synthetic, somebody could in theory get their hands on the disease and use it in biological warfare. If somebody did contract smallpox via whatever means, a lot of us would be in big danger. While the older population who have been vaccinated would be fine, those of us who haven't been would have a cause for concern. Doctors would do their best to contain an outbreak, and there would be mass quarantines. If the outbreak did turn into a global pandemic, then those under the age of 40 will be at the greatest risk. Those who contract smallpox will start to see an acute onset of fever. Red spots will appear all over the body, especially on the hands and face. These will then turn into blisters filled with fluid. When these pop, those who survive will be left with deep pitted scars. Last we knew it, smallpox's main form, the variola major, had a mortality rate of 30%, so millions of people could be at risk of dying, and many millions more being scarred for life. Of course, it goes without saying, those of us in first world countries with excellent healthcare will have a better chance of survival than those living in developing nations. With the potential death of so many young people, the world may be left with a higher percentage of older people, wiping out generations beneath them, which would be very sad and have many lasting issues for them in later life, with less young and able-bodied people to care for them in their old age. If smallpox ever did break out, the World Health Organization would act quickly. The good thing is, this time we already know how to vaccinate against the disease, so quick action would be taken to inoculate youngsters who have not yet come into contact with it. Even those who have been exposed to the pox stand a chance if they receive vaccination within 3 days. While there is no cure for smallpox, vaccination, even when you've already been exposed to the disease, can offer some protection or adjust the severity of the effects on your body. Of course, mass vaccination and medical care in this way would be very expensive and maybe economically crippling. So, that is what would happen if we had another smallpox outbreak. Do you have anything to add? Perhaps the calamity in this answer suggests that we need to be well prepared at all times for any kind of accidental or intentional outbreak of ancient diseases. Thank you guys for watching this video. If you found it interesting, please do give it a thumbs up and share it with a friend. Also, please do hit that big, beautiful notification button. I'm Rebecca Felgate, I'll see you in the next video, but for now, stay curious, stay alert, and never ever stop questioning. Still hungry for more answers? Why not check out our biggest science questions and our biggest what if playlist?